name is Christian Harris. I'm a CrossFit Games athlete and founder of Move Fast, Lift Heavy. We're going to be getting some footage of today's Saturday sweat from the MFLH online training program. So my crew and myself will be working out, throwing down. Also just know that this channel is going to be used for behind the scenes footage of the gear, as well as a podcast coming soon. So stay tuned for that stuff. So Move Fast, Lift Heavy started basically when I made my first regionals. I created a t-shirt design to help pay for the cost of the travel, so the hotel and all that stuff, my regionals registration. This is back in 2011. So I made a t-shirt design and people really liked the design that I made at the time, and just kind of got my wheels spinning into maybe starting a clothing company. I've always been into fashion, always been a creative person. So that's really how it was born. It was born in the gym out of putting in some hard work. MFLH, the clothing, aligns with the training now because it kind of brings both worlds to life. Move Fast, Lift Heavy, it's a lifestyle, it's a way to live, it's a way to train, and the two are basically merged together now. So what we have going on for today, a little Saturday sweat session, something I like to call like a power half hour, or like a power hour. This is just like a half version of that. It's probably my second favorite way to train. EMOMs are my favorite. Basically what you have here is a bunch of different workouts that are against the clock with some rest built into it. So the first part, we have a 1K row that's gonna take place between a 0 to 5 minute block. We should be finishing this row under 5 minutes, which is gonna be some built-in rest to that first 5 minute piece. Probably looking at somewhere around 1 minute to about 90 seconds. At the 5 minute mark, we're gonna do a 5 minute MRAP. All right, this one is gonna be a ladder of ascending reps. Got bar muscle ups and clean and jerks of the barbell, 135, 95, your standard weight on the barbell. So 5 minutes there. We're gonna have a 1 minute rest before getting into another 5 minute AMRAP. 12 calories for the gentleman, 9 for the ladies on the air bike, and 10 chest to bar pull-ups. We're gonna rest 2 minutes and then finish with a 12 minute AMRAP. More of a grinder type effort there. 15 toes to bar, 12, two dumbbell, dual dumbbell, box step overs, and then 90 double unders. That's what we have on tap for today. Yeah, it's gonna be fun. So usually during the week, I'll either work out alone or I'll have somebody jump in with me, like Deb. She pretty much trains with me for the most part during the week. On Saturdays, it's gonna be nice to work out with a group of people that are following that MFLH training program, just to kind of jump in with other people, have some fun, throw down, have some laughs, just kind of get a feel for where other people are at with their fitness, with their workouts, and so on and so forth.
What I like about the MFLH programming is not only the quality programming that you're getting, the demo videos that are right there on the app and easy to access, but also the coaching feedback that you get right on the app. If I have a question or, you know, want feedback on my score, the coaches are right there, ready to answer it.
If I could program an open workout this year, probably something with like rowing, cows, and thrusters, where you finish the work and in the remaining time, a one rep max snatch. I'd like to see that.
My strategy for this workout is honestly just trying to stay alive, just to try to get it done. I'm kind of new to the CrossFit world, so I don't necessarily have a strategy going in. I just want to complete it, and I'm happy.
How long do you guys think you're ready?
I'm sure for my grip that I put
down. Rocking.
Rattling.
So looking at today's training, my strategies. For the row, I'm gonna hammer that pretty hard. I'm not gonna go for a PR effort, but I would like to be very close to that 3 minute mark on the row. So I'll recover. We'll get into this ascending ladder here. My goal on this is gonna be to try to go unbroken on all the bar muscle ups. And the clean and jerks, I'm just gonna play that by feel. So I'll either start with some touch and go reps, but if I feel that my grip starts to get fatigued, I'm gonna definitely break on the clean and jerks and maybe go quick singles. But I definitely wanna try to stay unbroken on the pull-up bar the whole time. Just because if I break up a set there, there's gonna be more rest than if I'm just doing quick singles on the barbell. Then we have our other 5 minute piece. Air bike and chest to bar pull-ups. I'm gonna try to stay unbroken for this whole workout, and my pacing on the bike is gonna be hard enough so that I can make sure that as soon as I get off the bike, I'm right to the chest to bars. I think a lot of people, when they're doing workouts where it's a back and forth between two movements, they spend a lot of time in the resting or in the transition phases. So I wanna make sure that I'm pushing hard enough on the bike that I can get it done, but I'm gonna push myself, challenge myself to hop up on that pull-up bar immediately without too much transition time or too much rest. In this last effort, that's definitely gonna get very grip and shoulder intensive. Just being that you're hanging on the bar, you're gonna be hanging onto dumbbells, and then you have a jump rope that you're gonna be spinning for 90 reps at a time. Again, I'm gonna try to go unbroken on everything here. My transitions in this effort might be a little bit smoother in the sense that I'm not gonna rush to pick up the dumbbells, I'm not gonna rush to pick up the jump rope. I'm gonna take my time getting over there, I'll pick up the dumbbells, get those done, try to do it unbroken. I'll set them down, I'll pick up my jump rope, I'll take a nice breath, and then try to get the jump rope done. So I don't wanna rush through it because it's a little bit longer of an effort. If I'm, you know, really pacing quickly, my grip can definitely blow up real fast, faster than I want to. So those are my strategies for today. We'll see how it pans out. Today working out with the group, it was way more fun than it normally is. Being in here on a cold morning, in the dark. So, you know, the energy was up. And just like that camaraderie, again, like having somebody next to you to push you, motivate you, it definitely plays a factor for sure.
I broke that shit up 6 and 6. I'm like,
that's what I did.
Steak.
Last one.
That was good.
Step up?
Yeah.
So were you picking the rope right up?
Hell no.
That's, you know, I didn't.
Hey, I'll get there. You stick to the program, you'll get there.
I think after working out with the group and kind of looking around as the workout was going on and progressing, I could see that this program will definitely help people to get more fit overall. Also from a standpoint of scaling or using progressions during the workout, everyone was able to kind of figure out those progressions on their own, but there is notes in the program that specify, you know, if it's bar muscle ups, do something like a no push-up, burpee, pull-up, and so on and so forth. So it gives you that same feel of what the workout is supposed to be like, but not getting hung up on the complexity of the movement. Some things to look forward to from the MFLH training front. We're gonna have an individualized program coming soon, so for those that really want that one-on-one, completely custom, tailored attention, that's gonna be coming real soon alongside what we already have, which is the in-gym setup, your at-home or garage gym setup, or your minimalist setup. So keep an eye for that stuff coming soon. Hope to see you guys on the program.